Imagine this: perfect landscapes, rolling hills, delectable food, savory wine, enchanting melodies, beautiful art, prosperous and developed. Welcome to Italy, the enthralling romantic country with a culture-rich identity. A culture so passionate and lovely it is hard to escape. A country so scenic, even the greatest camera could not capture the beauty. And the people, so intriguing and unique, it is hard to leave. Upon entering the country, one must cherish the opportunity and understand that communication is the perfect way to delve into all of the miracles of Italy. While being a foreigner in Italy, it is essential to accept and thoroughly appreciate the Italian language, social norms, and the everlasting values that have shaped the country for years in order to communicate and succeed properly in the culture. Collectively, within the Italian culture, interaction is very prevalent. Between friends, family, and the general public, communication is well valued. Italian is the official language of Italy. In fact, 93% of the population are native Italian speakers. By comparison, in the United States, 80% of the residents claim that English is their mother language. However, there are several different regions and groups within Italy that speak different dialects of the Italian language. The dialects are known to range from the distinct local language and a regional variety dialect. The regional varieties include standardized Italian, Tuscan, Italo-Dalmatian, which is spoken in the countryside of Tuscany, Corsican, which is an Italo-Dalmatian Romance language spoken on Corsica and Sardinia, and Central Italian, which is a group of Italo-Dalmatian language varieties spoken in central Italy. These dialects differ rather dramatically to a point where two people from different regions of the country may have trouble communicating. Though spoken word is the most common use of communication in cultures across the globe, there is another nonverbal way to send messages from one person to another. Especially if you're struggling with the language, study up your nonverbal gestures and able to communicate. An Italian claim to fame is the hand gestures they use when communicating. This is not a myth. The Italians certainly like to use their hands to accompany their words. So before entering the country, make sure you shake those hands loose. In fact, many words have a universal hand gesture for all Italians, such as the movement for what? Which is performed by connecting all the fingers on a hand to form a beak shape and then moving that hand back and forth. Another common gesture, meaning let's go, is done by facing the palm of one's hand downward and moving the fingers up and downwards. When an Italian is frustrated with another individual, they will often use the nonverbal communication tactic, which means you're so hard-headed and stubborn, where one places one hand flat with their palm and put the other hand in a fist, moving it up and down, fisting the palm. Furthermore, when an Italian believes something to be too expensive, they will show it by rubbing their thumbs against their pointer and middle finger in order to indicate this is too expensive. When an Italian is trying to express the closeness between two friends, they will hold their hands together in a grip between fingers, with one hand facing up and one hand facing down. On top of that, the emotion, can you believe it, is expressed through facing palm to palm and laying each other finger on the identical and rocking hands up and down. The phrase, do you understand, is communicated by taking one's hand up to their ear and grasping the air and moving their hand back and forth. There are many gestures that go beyond just the Italian culture. Understanding and being able to utilize the gesture will further your abilities to travel throughout the world. In addition to these hand movements, you will notice the way Italians greet one another. Kissing on the cheek among acquaintances and embracing among friends is perfectly acceptable, Traditionally, all men and women walk arm in arm. However, this warm front is not always practiced. In public locations, people are not afraid to push and shove in order to move through a crowd. So get your own steady foot while walking through crowded areas. However, this does not mean that Italian culture is not welcoming. In fact, it takes pride in having very friendly and open personalities among the population, thus making the environment a more inviting and exciting place to travel. Not only are these modes of communication essential to practice, or at least to understand while traveling to Italy, but also are important values of the Italian culture. Other values of the Italian culture include the pace of life. Time is polychronic. This means that essentially time is unlimited. So if you're coming from a monochronic society, get ready to relax and enjoy time rather than plan it. Social gatherings, meetings, and everyday tasks are not done on a set schedule, but rather when time becomes available to an individual. So when in Italy, never rush. Those who live in a monochronic culture may struggle to adapt to the way Italians live. Dinners, tours, and meetings with Italian acquaintances will never be a quick time. In fact, you might as well clear your schedule for each of these events. On the same note, Italians also value collectivism. This means that life decisions are not based on personal gains and advancements, but only what benefits a group as a whole. Because of this, individuals are very dependent on their family and friends for guidance. Although, due to Italy's general Catholic nation, personal efficiency is very important. This means that life is not predestined, and how one chooses to live is entirely one's choice. This is a possible valid explanation for the polychronic Italian lifestyle. As a result, it is common for families to enjoy long Italian meals in order to relax, catch up, and reflect. Genders often affect how people interact in Italy. Socially and within the family, the Italian culture is masculine dominant. In the household, women are designated to homely chores far more frequently than men and sons. Also, when eating meals, the men are usually seated at the head of the table and serve first. This is respectively an old tradition that simply never faded. It is nationally accepted, and women have not acted against this. Although Italy is a masculine-dominant culture, equality is still practiced in the present day. In fact, Italians take pride in their respectfulness. With respect for others, Italians can avoid conflict. Their indirect approach results in happiness and bliss. In contrast, the Italians believe that directness brings conflict and discomfort to all situations. There is an obvious effort for harmony within Italian communities, which result in restful living. As the ancient Romans once said, "Eat, drink, and be merry." In order to have a successful experience in Italy, it is important to speak the Italian language, accept the social norms, and understand the cultural values. The culture of Italy is beautiful, renowned, and special to all who has lived or traveled to this incredible destination. However, in order to fully appreciate the country, it is important to interact with the Italian community in their mother language. This will lead into deeper relationships with all of the wonderful Italians. A trip to Italy is entirely what you make of it, so learn the language for the ultimate experience. Secondly, familiarize yourself with the social norms in order to truly live la dolce vita. Lastly, delve into the values and belief systems that have shaped the culture-rich nation. If so, you will take away lessons and experiences that would be impossible to gain without traveling here. Traveling to Italy is an opportunity of a lifetime, and in order to live your trip to the fullest, you must follow these few keys to success. Italy's beautiful people, delectable cuisine, breathtaking scenery, and enchanting music will never disappoint. You'll never want to leave.